page to write down. Imperfection in solids. What is imperfection? What is imperfection or defect?
The lattice
doesn't
have exact shape.
Hmm? Exact changes.
Yeah,
see, imperfection or defect is the change is in the arrangement of atoms. Not only arrangement of atoms, we can also say change in the properties of the atoms. When you heat this or when you mix some impurity into it, then the property changes from order arrangement to disorder arrangement. So this deflection from the ordered arrangement, whether in terms of properties or, you know, color or anything, you can say this deflection is nothing but the defects. Okay, defects or imperfections. Okay, imperfections possible when you heat the compound. Okay, heat kiya, electron ne heat gain kiya, and it jumps to the higher energy level. Okay, and because of that we have color changes also. Okay, so imperfection, write down the heading, imperfection in solids. Imperfection is nothing but the deflection from perfectly ordered arrangement. Deflection from perfectly ordered arrangement of constituent particles in the crystal. Write down next line. Perfect or ideal crystals can only exist at absolute zero temperature or zero Kelvin.
Can you repeat that?
Perfect or ideal crystal can only exist at absolute zero temperature. These defects may also change the properties of the solid. Like, you see one example, gemstones are the crystal of Al2O3. So Al2O3, and it is colorless. Okay, now when you add some impurities into it, suppose Fe3 plus iron you have added into this, then the color changes to blue, right? If you add Cr3 plus into this, the color changes to red, ruby red also. Okay, so these are the impurities. When you add those impurities into this gemstones, the color changes. So this is what the ordered, the deflection in the property we have, or perfectly ordered arrangement. If you are changing the position of atoms of the constituent particles, then that deflection is nothing but imperfection in solid. Imperfection is possible because of impurities or at high temperature when you heat this. Okay, two types of imperfection we have. Okay, two types of imperfection. Write down the first one, electronic imperfection. Electronic imperfection, as the name suggests, it happens because of electrons. Okay, electronic imperfections. Semiconductor, you have done in physics, p-type, n-type. Doping, semiconductor, okay. Electronic imperfection. It is because of irregular arrangement of electrons. Electronic means electrons, irregular arrangement of electrons. Okay, as the temperature increases, some of the electrons occupy the higher energy level and shows conduction. Okay, so when the electron leaves its original site, okay, suppose the electron is present here, right? Now when you heat this, or when you provide at high temperature, this electron jumps to the higher energy level. Okay, so we'll have a hole over here at the original side of the electron. Okay, this hole creates by the movement of electron from one position to another position. The concentration of electron, write down, the concentration of electron is represented by small n. Okay, hole is H, we represent the hole as H, and the concentration of holes is represented by P. Okay? Because of this transition only, the electron or the, you know, solids, whatever solids we have, that show conduction. Okay? Conductive nature is because of these electrons only, or this property only. Conductive nature is because of this. Both electrons and holes give rise to the conductive nature of the crystal. Okay, because of both of this only, the crystal shows conduction. So it is electronic imperfection is what? By the movement of electrons at higher temperature. Generally at absolute zero temperature or zero Kelvin, electrons are, there is no movement of electrons. And we can say there is no mobile electron present and no conduction is there. Okay, no mobile electrons and no conduction. When you increase the temperature, the electron occupies higher energy level, becomes mobile, creates hole. Okay, and both this mobile electron and holes give rise to the conduction in the solids. Okay. Next, you write down atomic imperfection. Atomic imperfection. Atomic imperfection, we also call it as point defect. Atomic imperfection or point defect. Write down. This type of defect is observed because of the movement of constituent particles. Okay, this can take place in two different way. When the constituent, the first one, when the constituent particles, when the constituent particles are missing from, constituent particles are missing from their original sites. Okay, missing from their original sites. And the second possibility is when the constituent particles are missing from their original sites and occupy interstitial vacant sites or the position of other particles. Any vacant site it occupies or the position of any other particles. Okay. Now this defect also, let me write down, atomic defects also classified into three categories. Okay, all these are not important, we'll see just two into this one. Three categories, the first one you write down, defects in stoichiometric crystal. Second one, defects in non-stoichiometric crystal. Third one, line defect or dislocation defect. Defect in stoichiometric crystal, defect in non-stoichiometric crystal, line effect or dislocation effect. These are the three different atomic defect we have. Okay. In this, the most important one is defects in stoichiometric crystal. You must have heard about Schottky defect and Frankel defect. Okay. Schottky defect and Frankel defect are observed in stoichiometric crystal. So write down the heading. Stoichiometric defect. Defect in stoichiometric crystal. Like I said, when the original position of the atoms are missing, suppose A, B atoms are arranged like this, A cation and B anion. Of defect, Frankel and Schottky mainly we have. So these are the position which is given to the various cations or anions here, A plus and B minus. Okay. Now if one of the cations or anions are missing from its original site. Suppose A plus or B minus yahan se aa gaya, theek hai? A plus and B minus. It is missing from the original sites. Okay? So this, earlier it was an order arrangement. When these two atoms are missing, ions are missing from their original site. Okay? Now this becomes a defect. The crystal is defect now, right? It is imperfection. The missing of these ions are imperfection of solids. Okay? So this missing, when the equal number of cations and anions, because the crystal as a whole should be neutral. Okay, so it's not like one A plus is missing and B minus is present. Electrical neutrality must be there. Okay? So when this kind of imperfection is there, this imperfection we call it as Schottky defect. SCH, don't write this much. It is Schottky defect. Equal number of cations and anions are missing from their original sites. Now it is also possible that A minus B minus is present here and A minus leaves its original sites and occupies any interstitial site like this. Okay? So this defect overall it is also electrical neutral. So when the ions occupies interstitial sites or the sites which is meant to be for any other ions or atoms of the crystal. Okay? या ये साइट को ऑक्यूपाई कर ले या किसी और आयंस का पोजीशन ऑक्यूपाई कर ले दैट पोजीशन शुड नॉट बी मेंट फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर आयन ओके सो दिस काइंड ऑफ डिफेक्ट वी कॉल इट एज फ्रैंकल डिफेक्ट ओके फ्रैंकल डिफेक्ट बेस्ड ऑन डेफिनेशन ओनली दे आस्क क्वेश्चंस ऑन दिस ओके कौन सा शॉटकी होगा कौन सा फ्रैंकल होगा सम प्रॉपर्टीज आल्सो वी हैव लाइक सपोज इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द डेंसिटी इन केस शॉटकी डिफेक्ट डेंसिटी क्या होगा कम हो जाएगा क्योंकि आयंस मिसिंग है ओरिजिनल साइट्स सो मास डिक्रीज होगा मास डिक्रीज होगा डेंसिटी डिक्रीज होगा इन दिस केस डेंसिटी वोंट चेंज क्योंकि मास तो है ही वहां ठीक है पोजीशन चेंज हो रहा है लाइक दिस वी हैव सर्टेन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ शॉटकी एंड फ्रैंकल डिफेक्ट ओके सो डिफेक्ट्स फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दीज टू डिफेक्ट्स आर प्रेजेंट इन स्टोइचियोमेट्रिक क्रिस्टल्स ओके फर्स्ट डिफेक्ट राइट ऑन शॉटकी डिफेक्ट जस्ट टू थ्री पॉइंट्स यू विल सी इन दिस डिफेक्ट equal number of cations and anions in this defect equal number of cations and anions are missing from their original sites and equal number of holes creates equal number of holes creates it is observed in ionic compounds aisa bhi question aata hai in which of these compounds Frankel defect observed a Schottky defect observed okay ionic compound of AB type for example NaCl KCl KBr AgBr CSCl etc NaCl KCl KBr AgBr CSCl etc. Okay, density decreases, lattice energy and stability also decreases. What about entropy? Entropy increases because disorderliness is increasing, right? So entropy increases in both cases, Frankel and Schottky. These are the 2-3 points we have in Schottky defect. Next, write down Frankel defect. Frankel defect. This defect is observed when an ion in bracket you write down usually cation changes its position right because cations are smaller in size when an ion usually cations of the crystal occupy any interstitial sites leaving a corresponding number of holes at the original site next one it is not observed in alkali metal halide alkali metal halide mein Frankel defect is not possible because size of cations and anions, the difference is not that much. Alkali metal halide mein, the difference is not that much, size difference, and that is why Frankel defect is not observed. Example, write down AgCN, AgBr, ZNS, AgI, etc. AgBr you take care of, in this both kind of defect is possible, Schottky and Frankel. Okay, last one maybe we have done this example, AgBr mein Schottky defect also possible. Okay, and this question they have asked once. You must keep that in mind that in AgBr both Schottky and Frankel defect possible. Okay, there is no change in density. Lattice energy stability decreases. Entropy increases. Okay. After this, we have defects in non-stoichiometric crystal. It is not that important. Okay. It's NCRT, it is given, you can go through. Non-stoichiometric crystal, we have again two types of defect. I'll just tell you here. One is metal excess defect. Metal excess, and other one is metal deficiency defect. Right, as the name suggests, metal excess defect is what? When the number of metal ions is more, right? Number of metal ions is more, you can achieve this in two different ways. Ya to metal ion ko add kar diya, right? By the addition of metal ion, or you remove anions. Removal of anions. Okay, then also the metal excess will be there, right? Metal deficiency is what? You add anion into this or remove metal ions. In both ways, the defect is possible. There's one term into this, you write down that F center, just definition you write down. F center, capital F center. Right, on when a negative charged ion, when a negative charged ion is missing from its original site, it creates a hole. And to maintain electrical neutrality, this hole is occupied by the electrons. Next line, when the electrons are trapped in anion vacancy, then it is known as F center. Okay, so basically from the another layer, the electron diffuse into the vacant site from which the anion has been removed. Okay, so when the electrons occupy that anion vacancy, see, when anions, suppose this cation is you know, it is not present in this site, when the cation leaves its original position, this vacancy we call it as cation vacancy, since cation is coming out from there. When anion comes out, it is anion vacancy. So when the anion vacancy is occupied by an electron, then this is known as F center of that. Okay, that is what the definition we have. Once they have asked question onto this F center. Okay, so when cation vacancy leaves its original site, it becomes the F center. One just last line into this: greater the number of F center, more will be the intensity of current, because more will be the electron transition. Okay, that's why the intensity increases. Okay, so these are the defect we have done, defects in stoichiometric crystal. Next we have to do this electrical and magnetic properties. Okay, electrical properties you have already done, this is p-type, n-type semiconductor we have, so that I am not doing it, right? Magnetic properties, there are 5-6 different types of compounds we have: ferromagnetic, ferrimagnetic, paramagnetic, diamagnetic, examples and all we'll see. And the last part of this chapter is that Bragg's law. Bragg's law we'll discuss, and then we'll see some questions. Okay.